Hi DIY family, for today's dry pour concrete experiment, we will compare regular mixed concrete to dry pour concrete. And this time we're going to be using the same amount of water for each. You might be asking why use the same amount of water. Well, we are using the same amount of water because the amount of water in the mix is the most important factor that determines the strength of the concrete. If you put too much water before the concrete is set, it can weaken the concrete, while too little water can make it difficult to work with. Another important factor is the temperature and humidity of the environment. A concrete cures best in warm and moist conditions. Generally, a concrete will reach about 70% of its final strength within the first 7 days after it's poured and 28 days for full strength. So once the concrete is set, it is best to keep it moist or wet until it reaches its full strength. So for today's test, I already filled all the small containers with dry concrete. Each of them is about 2.55 pounds. They are the same size and the same amount of concrete in them. And then what we will do is we will mix the first container using the slump test. And then we will use the same amount of water for the other two as well as for the three dry pour experiment. So for this video, we will break one sample from wet pour and another from dry pour after 72 hours. Then we will do two short follow-up video for the 7-day and the 28-day comparison. So let's get started. So let me go pick one of this and just pour this in this container. So what I'll do is I'll measure the amount of water that I'll be adding here. I have this 1/3 cup. So let's start with one. Maybe let's add another 1/3. This texture is perfect, but let me go add another tablespoon so that you can have more workability. Okay, so I think most people are gonna be mixing their concrete at this consistency. So let's go ahead and pour this thing on this one, and then we'll do the other two as well. Okay, so this is our first concrete. Okay, let's go do this one. So now with this one, we know that we need 2 1/3 cups and 1 tablespoon. Okay, so we're just gonna do the same thing. And let's go ahead and mix them together. Now let's do the third one. Okay, so let's get 2 of this filled up. 1, 2, and 3. Let me put that right here. Make sure I do not waste a drop of water because we want to get as close to how much water we put on the other three. Okay, so I'm gonna put this thing right here. We don't have to worry about how the top is gonna look like because what we're concerned about is the amount of water that is needed for the dry pour to actually cure properly. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and let it get around. Hopefully it's soaked through properly all the way to the bottom. And you notice I'm actually making sure that the sides are all covered, because I don't want to get any of the sides to give in. So we'll give it time to soak. Okay, so let me go ahead and pour some more water. Now I'm gonna concentrate more in the center. Okay, so I'm gonna start wetting this too. What I did is I actually put a hole in this water bottle cup and I poured the same amount of water on these two bottles. So I'm gonna start spreading this here, and then what I'll do is I'll keep adding water until I finish all this bottle right here, because I cannot add all of them at once because it's going to flood. So like this one right here. So I'm just gonna add them slowly until I finish all this bottle on this three. Okay, so I'm just gonna add water every couple of minutes so that I can finish this and give all the part of the concrete a chance to absorb the water that we're going to be putting in. You know, I don't want everything to be on top and just get wasted. So while it can absorb it, I will add as much water as I can. So it looks like the water have soaked through. This is the wet pour. And that is the dry pour. So the color is almost the same already. So it looks like it's soaking through properly. It's getting saturated properly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all of this aside. And then once it started to set, I'm going to start applying more water to it so that it don't dry out while it's setting. So let me come back to you after 72 hours. Okay, so we are now at 72 hours. If you look right here, everything in the front are the dry poured concrete. Everything in the back are the wet pour. And if you look right here, these are the wet pour. I have some air pockets right there. So basically when you do a wet pour, make sure that you agitate the sides properly so you get all the sides filled up, okay? Okay, so let's compare the top of the dry pour and the top of the wet pour. There's the side. And this is the bottom. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to do a little test on this dry poured concrete. I would like to see if this concrete can actually handle weight. I'm planning on driving my minivan on top of it and see if we can crack it. So at this point, we can say the concrete might have between 35 to 50% of its strength. So we'll see if this can handle a heavy load, and we'll just grab one of the sample because the rest of the sample, we're going to do more tests on it after 7 days and after 28 days, okay? So we'll grab this two sample right here. We'll drive our minivan on top of it and see if any of this will crumble. And if it does, let's see how long does the dry pour concrete take to crack as compared to the wet pour. And I'm gonna continue watering both of this. And in 7 days, we're going to do another test here. In 28 days, we'll do another test on another set. Okay, so we will put dry pour concrete on that side and the wet pour concrete on this side. And now we'll see if I can drive on top of it. Okay, so this is how dry pour concrete looks like after 72 hours and put into a stress test. Looks to me they are still powdered, right? See that? And let's go ahead and check the other one. Now this is the wet poured concrete. The wet poured concrete has set better. It did crack on the sides, and this is the there's also some crack there, but it was able to hold the weight of the van. Okay. So we do understand that the dry pour concrete will take longer for it to cure. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do the test again in 7 days, and then we're gonna do another test in 28 days, okay? So for now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna continue watering both concrete so that they can both absorb a lot more water, and then we'll do another test in 7 days. So make sure to click that subscribe button so you can get updated when I upload that video. And thank you for watching.